Oh my God, it's only Brandon and Ronnie from the Killers! You okay, Ronnie? You still?
Yeah, I'm fine. I can see my stare. Yeah. Looking good.
This is great because we've interviewed you a couple of times during the COVID era on Zoom, and it's been so long since we've. It's so great
it's nice to
finally
be here in person. Yeah. Nice. I like this. I like this desk.
Brandon, you've told us in past interviews that you're not a huge fan of the typical rock star lifestyle. So I'm wondering, Ronnie, as the drummer, does that mean that you get to pick up the slack in that department?
All of it.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, taking one for the team.
Now, you guys are going to be coming back here at the end of the year, but right now, I've got it on good authority that Gorillaz is touring, and at one of their Sydney shows, they didn't play their famous song, Dare. Is there any situation that you could conceive that you would head into a show and not play Mr Brightside?
No, there's been one. We played in Amsterdam, and that's the only time that we've withheld that song. Mm. And I think I was just in a bad mood.
Oh, okay. I was like, why? Why are we punishing the fans?
Oh, I've never discussed it. It was just didn't feel right. But we just recently played. We finished our European tour in Amsterdam, and it was one of the best.
The apology.
It was one of the best nights. I think that they were paying us back, and it was one of the best nights of the tour. But I never understood bands that withhold the song that people are paying money to see, and maybe that's just. It's a part of who we are, or we're people pleasers.
Yeah,
but like there was a long time where Radiohead didn't play Creep and things like that, and I just.
And Billy Joel with Just the Way You Are for a long time.
For a long time, yeah. So anyway, there are some people that it's going to be their first time hearing that song.
Yeah.
And you know, we feel obligated in a way. They're paying to see us, and you know. Give him a little bit.
Totally.
A little bit, just a little bit.
Yeah. I don't know if you're aware of this, but Mr. Brightside is still on the charts here in Australia. It's number 28 as we speak. Is that...
You look very confused. Yeah. Yeah,
is that crazy to you, or are you just like, yeah, that makes sense because it's a sick song?
Nothing about what we do makes sense to me. That's amazing. That's great. 28.
Is it on right now in Australia?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
28.
Totally.
Well, hopefully after this show, we'll make it to 25.
Where's Kylie, by the way?
You were expecting Kylie in the building.
We sort of, they dangled Kylie.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, Kylie. Yeah,
they dangled Georgie. Kylie Minogue.
They misspelled it. It was Georgie. Kylie with a G. Yeah,
that's why I'm here.
With the charts, though, is that something that you guys... follow it all? Do you look at them still these days? Because we understand that they are success is rated in a different way, right? So is it something that you're across?
We get that information on the spot on TV shows. We don't surf.
Well, then how do you guys measure success then? What to you is like you've released it, getting by, yeah. Mr. Brightside, and you're like, damn, that's good.
It's changed since we were young. For instance, our last record is called Pressure Machine, and it's a very different record for us. It's not a typical Killers record, but it was a lot more rewarding for me personally to write that record than to have a song that was topping the charts.
Right.
So you got to find out what makes you happy, and that changes with age, I think.
I reckon doing a song with Bruce Springsteen would be pretty.
That was a COVID treat.
Yeah, and obviously I know how much Bruce Springsteen means to you, but I'm intrigued by what happened. How did that?
It was cool. How much time do we have?
I'll be trying to be fast.
It really was. So we were in New York and we were promoting Imploding the Mirage, and we got told in New York that. Everything was going to shut down, and you could kind of continue promotion at your own risk.
Oh, wow.
And we decided to go home, I was at the airport, and I started getting these texts, and they were from Bruce Springsteen, but I didn't have his number saved on my new phone. And I've never said this before, but there were emojis, and there were grammatical errors that I didn't associate with him. And
we're just replying, stop.
And so I wasn't sure that they were there, like guitars and
flexing.
And hearts and flexing and things like that. But he's just been a beautiful inspiration in my life and gives me something to shoot for and all of that.
Well, speaking of jamming with famous friends, you've been secretly jamming with Prince Harry. Who knew he even played a musical instrument? What does he play?
That's you.
Oh, Harry and me. We trade and licks on the guitar.
So he's a guitarist, Prince Harry.
He does a lot of finger tapping. Kind of...
No, we're talking about the guitar.
Yeah.
Prince Van Halen.
And we're rapping.
Okay, for all the details on how you can catch the Killers Imploding the Mirage Tour, please head to our website. Brandon, Ronnie, thanks so much for joining us.